All right, so here we go. Welcome in. It is March 18th. It's Thursday, 12:06 p.m. Yesterday, y'all, everybody see my screen fine? Drew, Dwayne, Jim, everybody's good. Where's that slackered mad at today? All right, and we know that Ken's not going to be here today. He's on vacation with his daughter, so he may check in here and there. But here's what we got to figure out, y'all, is that when you find an opportunity, right, you got to take advantage of it. So we are in the business of buying low and selling high. Now, the problem is most of the time we do that in reverse, which is an amazing thing, is we, but if we do, well, we're positioned quite nicely. Friend, let's put this at today's, let me go there. And what happens to our account if volatility increases? Well, y'all, some amazing stuff happens, doesn't it? And the amazing thing is, as volatility, as VIX goes up, let's say, now VIX went up to 80. What happens to our account? Well, follow the VIX. We're up $7,000. We're up $9,000. It's not bad, is it? Now, of course, a lot of our other trades are losing. We are sitting pretty. So that's just showing you what we showed for it. You know, eventually, but over here, if it were to happen today, we're up 11 grand if you were to shoot up big time. But what happens, y'all, is it gets even better than that, right? Because, so what happens if vol in increments, you're up 13,000. Aren't we? So we're out here. So what happens if the market goes up? Market goes up, Sweet Bobby makes 10 bucks. I cannot lose going up on my spy position. Look what happens here. You see, you got problem. What it shows here is that, so look a little, if we expire today, in 2 days, we're going to be up $647. And in April 17th, we're going to be up $1,500. Crawl on stuff, knock it off. So we kind of analyze tab. If you are, you're ahead of, you know, gosh, 90% of the people that have no idea what this thing is or what it does. All right, so you know, Mr. Broken Record, here we're going to do. Why are you down there, baby? Going over here. The range. We are Ranger Dan or Dave. Who is it with Yogi Bear? I can't remember. All right, so today, I'm so excited. I think I can file my taxes today. Stupid H&R Block tax cut program. I love it, by the way. If you're doing your taxes between TurboTax and H&R Block, I've tried both. H&R Block is so much more intuitive for me. Right? I don't like TurboTax. So let's see what our net leak is for today, so we can roll on down this river that you and I roll down each and every day. How is Sweet Bobby doing? Scared to look, actually. Hate this Apple phone with the eye thing. I was playing with my mama's today, and hers has the thumb thing on it. So we are at 51,560.81. Okay. So how does that mean that we're doing today? Cute effects. Not trying to be Jim Cramer or anything, but I did this, y'all, before I was coming in here with y'all every day, right? I would just do this each and every day because I'd go, hey, man, we're up. Well, what are we up? Come here, stupid spreadsheet. Tell me what we're up, you stupid thing. Okay, well, so we're up $157 on the day. Beautiful. What's wrong with my Jeffersons?
Anyway, probably. I was trying just to get up that hill. No, we up in a big league.
That's the.
What the crap was that? What in the name of God did I just put on my. At least we didn't have any cussing or anything.
We are the champions, my friend.
All right, so now, dang it, I wanted to hear the Jeffersons. So let's see what our deltas and all that kind of stuff is. So like, everybody down today? Positive deltas yesterday, so let's think about that. If we're positive yesterday and we're negative today, that means the market went what direction? Anybody? Because that's a question you got to know, right? You got to know that. Market goes up, we'll get negative jobs. Mm-hmm. Right? What was that, Dwayne? You going to say something?
I said it went down.
Went down, didn't it? Let's look at it. So the market's down just a bit, right? Market's down just a bit. But now all of a sudden, I've got more increased negative. I have equipment for it. It was a good thing. I don't know what it was. 27 or something. And then it pops up our ratio. So we're good. We want this between 0.1 and 1%. So it's telling me that my risk is good. How much buying power are we using? So since we left yesterday, I did put on a couple of other trades, didn't I? I put on the SPX Rick trade, and I put on a, what else did I put on? I put on the Cameron Skinner trade yesterday. I don't think we did that together, but let's look at our buying power used. 19,251. Dang it. 19,251. Now, if you don't want to keep up with your buying power and how much you're using and all that, other than to say, try not to go over half, right? Over 50%. So you and I are using 37% of our buying power. Where should we be? Between about 35%, right? Got all the formulas on your spreadsheet. No adjustment. Oh, check that out. So the spreadsheet's saying, hey, Bobby, you're a little bit short. In order to be neutral, you need to increase your deltas by... You could actually go out and purchase 16 shares of SPY, or you could sell puts or do any combination of things to make sure that you get positive deltas. And I love that. I love it because that's my favorite thing, y'all. That's what I love doing. I love coming in here and just saying, man, I'm going to sell puts because I hate calls. And I hate when this says I need negative deltas, right? Oh, my gosh. Butterfly. I got my income checks. It's giving me positive theta still, and it's giving me just a tad of, you know, negative vega. It's up 95, well, 88%. It's kind of flitching around. The maximum profit on this is $150, right? That's what I put that on for $150. I mean, theoretically, I could take it off, but let's analyze it. Let's see. Let's analyze the 1-2-1. Let's see, this only let me analyze a closing order. So let's do that. Analyze closing order. Why are you showing up on that screen? Let's see what this looks like. It's probably not the way I want to do it. So if we go vertical roll there, so let's just see what she looks like. So she's a 1-2-1, and she's a 38.80, 39.90, and a 39.10. So let's take all that off. And then we'll just grab those strikes. So we'll go there. We'll go short, and then we'll go there. So this should be our butterfly, right? 1-2-1. All in the, make sure I got the right stuff. All right, so let's go, we'll do one expiration, because they're in the same expiration. There we go. Beautiful, yeah. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So let's just look and see what we got here. So I could close it today, right? But what I'd really like to see on this position, now it's part of it, this is a tree, right? It's a tree in our forest. So we're just saying, hey, buddy, jump up on the table, bend over, cough, touch your knees, your ankles, whatever. What I'd love to see on this, if we're looking at this tree, right? Here's where price is, right? Where's price? Price is right here, $39.66, right there. So what I'd love to see is this thing expires tomorrow. Man, wouldn't you like to see price curl up in here and all of a sudden you get you about a, get you what, $1,005? Oh, son, would that be sweet? Oh, would that be sweet? All right. So I like that. So let's go to Tastyworks. Give it a second to open. Because what I'd love to do, we put on this trade last Thursday. I don't know. That is what? It took up $1,000. We got options and we can close that. Bad news, aren't they? 42 positive deltas in here. Hold on a second. Good trade. Yeah, I'm checking. Still is volatility. It's low here. It's only up. Now look at our friend, the VIX. is up 3.64%. A great day to sell premium. And you should be selling premium today is in oil. Oil. OVX. So the oil volatility is, so how do you tell it? All right. Well, what you do is you start thinking, man, it's getting tax time. I want to sell something that's advantageous to me. Something called 1256 ETFs. If any of y'all have things that I can trade. XSP, which is the SPY, but in a more favorable fashion, this 1256 contract. It doesn't have to be the SPY has, but I like trading it. Never had a problem with it. Gold. There's gold, right? And here's USO. USO is a 1256 contract. Gives you 60% of 10 that you have the profits on that were held for greater than a year. And if y'all don't understand the benefits that y'all, it's just it's a beautiful thing. And hopefully Uncle Joe and Aunt Nancy ain't going to take that away from us. Right? We hope they leave this. Shh, don't leave us alone. We're not the hot shot gazillionaires out there, right? We're just hardworking people coming in the market every day trying to pull out a penny. So leave us the good stuff. So if you want to trade something today, I highly recommend. Don't recommend anything, Bobby. You get sued. I understand. So I would say go into, USO. Capital R. All right. Let me try to get into that. All right. So. All kinds of things that we can do there. So nothing that we need to do. I just can't wait for tomorrow, y'all. Tomorrow is payday, right? Tomorrow is payday. I could close them today, but I am a greedy capitalist. And I believe in the plan that we got going on. And the plan says, hold them to tomorrow, Bobby. Close these puppies out tomorrow. And hopefully we're going to squeeze out just a little bit more out of this onion, right? Now, what if all this crap is 169? Micros, you are afraid you're going to lose money, you freaking idiot. So we put 725 in there. I thought we put 725 in there. 725. Oh, that's getting on my nerves. Yeah. Hey, there's Matt.
If you take one off every day and add one on, you're always going to have the same number of positions on, right?
Yes.
Yep. So how do you ever get more than one? If you start out with a clean slate and you add one, and then the next day you take it off and add another one, how do you ever get more than one? That's sort of a facetious question, but how many do you put on?
That's a great question, Dwayne. And what I would tell you is this. What can your account absorb, right? So, it really all comes down to your Greeks, right? So few people that you'll find manage accounts like we do, right? We're kind of in your account. So what I would do is get your campaign with all these campaign trades. Technically I should be at 35%. So I could even close two today, right? And put on one. I could close two, put on one. That would take away a little bit of my buying power usage. So what can your account consume? So it's kind of like you're taking, you run out of gas and all you got is a milk jug. And then you go to the gas station to get some gas in there and you walk, right? I know if you've got me, you've done that several times. You go, man, I know I can make it to the next exit. And then the next thing you know, you're stranded on the side of the road and you ain't got nothing. And you find a milk jug or a 2-liter Coke bottle on the side of the road. And that's what you got because you don't want to buy a gas can at the convenience store because they charge you $30 for one. So you go there and you say, okay, how much gas am I going to put in here? Well, you don't want to put it to the very top because when you're walking back on that highway because you're too scared to hitchhike because you're afraid Jeffrey Dahmer is going to have you in the freezer with barbecue sauce, then you go, well, I probably don't want to get too full because, I want my arm to relax and that jug's going to be, tilted a little bit. So if I fill it up too much, I'll start losing gas. So I'm probably going to go about, I just need enough. I don't really care if gas is too heavy. I don't want someone to throw a cigarette out and me explode with too much gas. So you go, if I get about, if I get half a gallon in there, I'm good. So that's what you do, Dwayne. You start filling up that jug that you're going to have to walk with and carry day by day or hour by hour to get back to your car. Because I know Matt's run out of gas. How many times, Matt? Probably 10, right? He's stranded on the side of the road. So that's what you do. So you go, how much can my account afford? So you start building all these trades in and all these different, you know, you go broken wing butterfly. Guess what we're going to do? Y'all still don't even know everything we're going to do. We're eventually going to add a calendar campaign. We're going to be putting on calendars in our account. And you can do that in anything. You can do that in micros. You can do what are called calendar. Don Kaufman refers to them as volatility bombs. I mean, all kind of garbage. And I shouldn't call it garbage, right? I call everything garbage. But it's, yeah, we got all kinds of little campaigns that we do. So you start your campaign with one. So, Dwayne, if you're starting this today, put on one, right? Then keep an eye on your Greeks, your buying power, and then put on one tomorrow, then put on one the next day, then put on one the next day. And then when you go, oh, man, I'm up about 35% of my buying power, or if you're one of those that says, you know what, Bobby, screw 35%. As long as I'm under 50%, I'm good. And I encourage you, don't ever go over 50%, right? We've done it a couple of times, but what do? We adjust and we get down, right? So utilize the buying power you have to get your campaigns going. And once you get your campaigns going, then start peeling stuff out. Start peeling stuff off. Does that answer your question, Dwayne? And listen, if you like, you know, just like if you want me to go one-on-one and let's just look at your account and go in and help you do that, that's what I'm here for y'all to do. So anytime you need some, you know, you don't want to say something out front of other people or something, then, and trust me, I'm not going to say anything that y'all say in front of anyone else, right? You keep it on the down low. Or you want me to do that, then I'll do that. Not that I know anything, right? Y'all seen, I'm the world's worst. My gosh, you see me doing dumb stuff. And if, without this spreadsheet, oh my gosh, I'm just an idiot. I don't know what to do. So I need this to give me discipline. And hopefully that's how you'll build yours up. So start with one, then go two, three, four, five, fill up your account. And you may say, Bobby, I ain't going to do all that other junk you do. I'm just going to do a micros campaign. This is the best trade on the board. Well, fill up your 50% buying power or 35% buying power. Fill it up with the micros. What was I doing? All right, so we closed one. Did I put that in? Did I tell everybody we did it? Let's see, 7.25. Go to the micros. Did I do 7.25? There she is, right? I don't think I closed her out though. So we took our $69, which doesn't sound like a lot, but y'all, we just do it day in, day in, day in, day in, day in. So we got out of that trade on today, which is the 18th. Just putting them on, closing them on, putting them on, putting them on. Boring garbage, y'all. Boring. And this ain't meme stocks, and it's not GME, and you're not tendies and diamond hands. You're just boring coming in and taking those people's money. That's what we're doing. We've taken from the dumb and given to the enlightened, so to speak. I don't want to sound lofty. But look, y'all, this number just keeps going up, and I promise you, it's just going to keep going up. Now, you'll see days, they'll start going down. We'll take a few losses here, and it'll be down. But overall, the odds are in our favor. Look at this, y'all. We're on track. Keep it in a $40-something-thousand-dollar account. Now it's 50, right? But we're on track to make $10,000 just with this. I ought to shut everything else down. I should shut it all down and just do this. But I believe in my other trades too, right? So let's click our net $69. Yeah, you didn't make $10,000 in GME today on a long time. Look at this. What is this? With 2 Leadbetter dogs who are the worst dogs on the planet with goats, hogs, chickens, and I ordered some Royal Purple Guineas from some hatchery today. They'll be here in June. If you never heard of Guinea, they look like babies. I don't own an outside business. I don't run nothing at the flea market. I don't, you know, have a store where I'm sitting there puffing on a Lucky Strike every day, selling, you know, stuff to people. I don't have to go into an office. I just sit right here, man, do my thing. And I sold $38,000 worth of stuff. Well, Bobby, did you have to advertise that stuff? Did you have to pay advertising fee? No. Well, did you have to have vendors? Well, yeah, I got Thinkorswim. How much you pay them? Well, let's see. I pay them $31 a month because I have to subscribe to data because I'm a partnership. And I pay for a couple of partnerships and LLCs every year for different trading accounts. And, you know, I do my own taxes. I save money there. You know, it's pretty good, right? How many employees you got, Bobby? I ain't got none. It's just me and my unrowdy kids that are behind me. And I've sold $38,000 worth of stuff. Y'all, time this year is over just in this one account. We're going to sell over $100,000 worth of stuff. We got to advertise. We got a ready buyer when we're ready to sell. I mean, I'm in liquid products, the most liquid of products. Think of what a great business that you and I have, right? Matt's sitting there and he's, you know, got the, he's working as the crossing guard at school, getting extra money in his account. Bingo. He's found the secret to success, right? Not that we're always going to make money, but I feel pretty good, you know, over 200% last year. Am I going to do 200% this year? I don't know. We'll see. Maybe. Looks like a slow start this year, doesn't it? But y'all, look what we're doing lately, right? Yeah, we sucked a little bit here, right? But keep in mind, from our premium selling, we have collected $3,557 in this one account. That's pretty darn good. And it's going to get better. Guess when it's going to get better? Y'all wait till tomorrow. You ain't seen jack crap yet. Then guess what? Wait till next Friday, because you ain't seen jack crap yet. So we're just going to keep doing this every stinking week. And then Bobby's got to remember a couple of things. Bobby, stay out of the stuff that you're not good at. Why in the devil would you be in Baba? Why in the devil would you be trading, you know, Clover? And why would you be trading on such a stay in the S&P 500, find a couple stocks that you like. Matt likes fuel cell. That's good. You know, find a few that you like and sell premium in them. Get to know those. Don't be looking for trades. I don't have to look for anything anymore. Remember when we started out, and I told you my mistake was this. My mistake with y'all was this. When I started out, I said, if I don't trade stocks, they are probably going to hate this because they'll think it's boring. And I didn't want y'all to be bored. I really didn't. I want y'all to go, well, it's kind of, you know, it's kind of cool. It's kind of entertaining. So then I have to weigh, well, what's more entertaining? Is it more entertaining going out and searching for new meme stocks or something to trade every day? Or is it more entertaining putting money in the pocket? Well, I soon came to the conclusion that we can be boring all day long, right? Doing the same thing over and over and over. But y'all, that's where the money's made. Gosh, trust me, I've chased it all. I've chased earnings. Oh, and then I did an IBM earning, and I got my butt handed to me. And so guess what? I got a few burns like that, and I go, I'm not trading IBM earnings. Are you kidding? And then I stopped trading earnings altogether. And then just like Karen the Super Trader, oh, I can't stand Karen the Super Trader, whatever. Karen the Super Trader said, the simpler I made it, the more profitable I got. The simpler I made it, the more profitable I got. And why should you and I complicate things? Let's trade S&P 500. It's a lot of stuff we can trade, right? Let's trade the overall market, the Qs, the IWMs, the, you know, the NASDAQ, the Russell. Let's trade all that stuff, the overall market, so that we don't have to be looking at Reddit and Wall Street Bets and, you know, Theta Gang and all these places. Oh, I'm looking for stocks, you know. Come, stop it. Find me a few and be done with it. That's fine. You want DraftKings? We got DraftKings. I'm going to have me 100 shares by this time of the year's over. Well, Bobby, everybody and their mama's out there trading the wheel. So are we. So are we, y'all. We trading the wheel, too. Y'all just ain't seen me get a sign. You know why? Because I don't get a sign most of the time. I can't ever think of me ever being a sign. Well, I got a sign the other day. I got a sign in ES, didn't I? So, it, I mean, it happens. But that's not my purpose. We're just selling premium. That's our game. Right? That's our game. And y'all, you see this, oh, Bobby's only made $3,557 this year. Boy, does he suck. Y'all wait till tomorrow. Y'all wait till next Friday. You wait till the Friday after that. You wait till the Friday after that. Because they laughed. They laughed at Noah, right, when he's building the ark, right? You remember his kids, they make fun of him. Like, what the crap, Daddy? And he's like, well, that's what I need to do. So he's building an ark. That's what I did last year, right? Because I built an ark because I said, man, the crash is coming. The crash is coming. It's coming. And I was ready for it. Boom. Hit. And I told y'all the story, trembling in the podiatrist's office about to get my toe cut off, going into the hospital. And here I am trembling because, you know, I just doubled my count in the day. So the exciting times do come. They don't come often. But most of the time, we're ready for it. So, you know, this year, I'm doing a little slightly different because I'm going with stuff that I back tested 2016, 2018. I'm getting more of our income trades, right? Now, I could sit here and be Nostradamus and say, we're going to do nothing but the hedge. Man, we're going to be hedge and we're going to wait. And then y'all sit here and be like, man, this is boring, Bobby. We come here every day and it ain't happening. And I say, yeah, but the days are coming, y'all, when your hand's going to tremble. And you're going to pull off the side of the road and you're going to start crying and trembling because you don't know what to do. So we're kind of leveling that out a bit, right? Because now we've got a lot more income trades in the portfolio. But trust me, this is all stuff that I believe with a high level of confidence works. Going into BABA and Goldman Sachs and doing some of those trades, I mean, that was fine, but it didn't help us, did it? Didn't help us at all. So now I finally got back on track. Because I am eat up with human raw emotions as well. You know, if anyone ever comes on here and says, man, I got this stuff is easy. It's the same thing over. No. Because even I go and say, I want to find something shiny. Oh, it is the struggle of the trader, y'all, to go in and say, man, I got to find something shiny today. Let me just show you something. It's in our Discord room. Where's my Discord button? Here we go. Go and look at this. I hope y'all have read this, and I hope you've listened to the video on it. Go into resources, right? Go to resources, and I've got the best of the best of the best here. I don't put much in here that I don't think is gold. You ought to be listening to Mark Douglas every day. How many of you hadn't even listened to this? It's probably, what, 8 hours or so? Listen to it. It's free. It's on YouTube. Right? You need to be listening to this. These podcasts are good. This is a good segment, Probability of Turnaround. I put the best of the best of the best of research and inspiration here. Not everything goes here. Only the best of the best of the best. And there is this thing called Options Genius. And I listen to his podcast a lot. And some of them are good, some are bad. He just doesn't tell you how he trades, right? So there's this thing called the Ultimate Options Trading Strategy. And if you haven't listened to this, shame. You need to be listening to this. Because what it talks about is a guy, what was his name? Can't remember. Who kept trying one thing after the other. So what he did is he said, man, I'm going to start off with the Iron Condor. Then he said, I'm going to do ratio. I'm going to start following them. I'm going to start doing. You want to pay $99 a month or an extra $200 a month to be in Theo Trade? Go for it. I love Theo Trade. I love Don Kaufman. I love the guys at Theo Trade, right? I spend $300 a month to be in that room. And I wasn't doing half the stuff that they were doing. And it was good. You know, it was good. And I learned everything. And I kind of got to a point that I go, I kind of know what I need to know from Don Kaufman and his group. So what I'm bringing to you is I bring to y'all the stuff that I learned from that group. Then you go, well, what about have you subscribed to Stratagem Trade with, what's his name? I can't remember the guy's name. Yes, I have. I have paid to be in that room $300 a month to be in there. Yep. I was in there a long, long time. And I don't want to criticize him, but he trades in a paper account. And you don't see his trades live. And that kind of got to me. And I'm like, well, I kind of learned enough here. I'll get out of that. So guess what I do? I bring that to y'all, what I learned from that room. Then I was in Scott Stewart's zero ZTE trade. I love Scott. I think Scott does great stuff. You know, I pay $250 a month to be in his room. I did. And then I go, Oh, this is killing me, man. I'm a day trader. I don't want to be a day trader. I want to take a nap every day. I want to go out and play with the, you know, I want to play with the goats and milk the chickens. So, you know, I didn't have time to sit in a screen all day. And so I kind of learned all this stuff, and I learned from Tasty Trade. I still am engaged with Tasty Trade on a daily basis. I get the best stuff. And what I do, you ain't got to watch Tasty Trade. You know what I do? I scour it. I got four or five shows that I don't miss every day, and I bring the research to you. And I took the research from all this stuff, from Option Alpha, from, you know, Strategy and Trade, from, you know, all this stuff, and I built it into a spreadsheet so that you don't have to pay $250 a month for this one or $250 for that or $99 for this or whatever for that. And I bring it all to you, and I do it on a daily basis. And I hope that you find value in it, because if you're wanting to chase the meme stocks, then this probably isn't the place to be, right? If that's your bread and butter. But what I'm teaching you is I'm not giving, what is it they say, don't give a man a fish, you know, teach him two fish, right? So, yeah, by now, y'all been with me for what? Since December, every one of them. So, by now, you know, you really could do this on your own. And that is the goal. Y'all tell me the stuff that y'all are going through and sharing. And it's, y'all have what you need in front of the game that you, you know, coming, you're going to take, you know, it is God, y'all make microbes, right? Bobby, I don't have Bobby bringing in enough that I'm doing more spreads now, but you know, it's nothing for me to swing out a naked. Naked doesn't care me. You know, I love seeing these people. Oh, it's got to be cash secured put. If it's not cash secured, you're just playing with the devil. And I go, y'all have no idea what y'all are talking about, because you're looking at one tree. Don't look at the tree, look at the forest. And when your forest is in good shape, then you can prune your trees, and your bad trees don't, you know, hurt you so much. Y'all, I've got SPX trades expiring tomorrow with $2,000 worth of risk that I ain't even looked at. I ain't even looked at them. I don't care. I care. I want them to close. I want to close them tomorrow, and they'll be profitable on our payday, right? But if they're not, what am I going to do? Y'all know what I'm going to do. Broken record, man. We're going to roll her out in time. All right, we'll accept our loss for a day. We'll go out in time. Because when you're trading the S&P 500, time is on your side better than if you're trading GameStop, who will ultimately be Blockbuster. Right? GameStop is Blockbuster. And people, I see GameStop as well. And going to the go up quickly. Most of the business decisions in my life have gone around. My people, we don't even figure out that we were going to ship goats to Cuba. How are you going to do that? So quickly, we lost money in the goat business. Then I started a second business. I was in real estate, very successful in real estate. We flipped houses. We buy foreclosures, just the stay-ups. Very good. I'm a real estate broker, blah, blah, blah. You know, because I got tired of paying other people's commissions. So I wanted to be the broker. So someone come up to me, and y'all remember the real estate books that you see at all the restaurants, and you go to a convenience store and you could pick up a real estate book, right? And you flip through and see the houses that you wanted to go see. So several years ago, a person approached me who owned a real estate advertising business, you know, the brochures and the books. And said, hey, I'm getting out of the business. Would you like to get in? I go, man, that sounds like a great, great